So our next project, we're doing two custom vanities for my customer, and she really likes our bungalow table. So this is done in that style, which is has elements of mission and prairie, and just early 20th century style details. It's all going to be quarter sawn white oak, which means we're going to pay close attention to the grain because we want the best grain showing the most, as is always the case. And this is the basic configuration of it. So we're going to start, as I often do, by just making the doors. We have a central door here, and then the drawer fronts are just flat slab. And those we just pay very close attention to the grain. We went to our hardwoods place. And the last time I was there a couple months ago, they were getting a little skinny on quarter sawn white, so I wasn't too optimistic. But when I went in, they had filled an entire bunk with these incredibly wide, beautiful pieces. They're actually quite straight and flat as well, which quarter sawn often is. On quarter sawn wood, you are taking, essentially, you're taking the log, cutting it in half. Here's the center, and the quarter sawn is cut like this out of it. The sawyer will take it out like that. So this is the end view of this piece. And now he has to keep it a little bit away from the center because you don't want this, the center is not good. So maybe there might be 4 inches here to here. So the tree they must have taken these pieces out of, this must have been an impressive white oak tree. This is a little over, it's about 12 and 3 quarters. You're talking about a tree that was upwards of 30 inches in diameter. I don't know where they find white oak trees like that, but this came from that. So I'm going to do all the doors. So I have a cut list of all the parts I need. I'm going to take them from this beauty right here. So we're going to do some rough milling to start. We have our stiles and our rails cut to their final net width and length. The next step is we're going to cut the cope joints on all the rails. The cope joint slides into the slot that goes on the stiles. It also goes into the slots that are on the rails. This is the tooling that I choose for this because it's the only one I know of where you can adjust the thickness of the slot. So you're not stuck with one cutter cutting a quarter inch slot. This one has a fine adjustment in it. It's very nice actually. It's made in two parts. It's made by Freud. And the two halves come apart and there are bushings in between or little spacers. They go down to 2/1000ths of an inch and there's a little stack. So you can get right down to the 1/1000th. So I have my 2 hours ready to go that I'm gonna use for this. So my next step is to put these in, adjust the thickness, and cut the copes on the end of our little rail. they're just decorative end tenons that are going to go on there. On the tapered one, we have a 4-inch one here because that is where this arc, this little apron in the toe kick, ends, and where the drawers start. It's 4 inches. We need 2 4-inchers. That's these two. Then we need 2 3-inchers because those are slightly less. So then we get something that looks like this when it's done. Looks more or less like that. Anyway, we don't put them on the sides because in reality, you would never have a tenon going through one side and through the other. They would interfere with each other. It's going to go through one or the other, and we want to see them on the front. So that's these, and then we will just put a little glue on there, making sure it doesn't squeeze out, and then we'll put a couple of pin nails right through there, and that should hold it forever and ever. So, next step is to cut out our tapered legs here. So now we are cutting the all-important tapered legs that go in the master bath vanity, the smaller of the two. According to the drawing here, which is where we worked out the proportions on this, the base is 4 inches and the top is 2.5. So that's your taper. Now, there are many ways to do this kind of a cut. Some people would try to set up a tapered jig on and run it through the table saw. I might do that if I was doing 10 of them, but I'm only doing this one. And I've selected a piece which has some nice flakes in it. It has some nice rays. And so that's what we want on the front. We've already cut our little tenons, our stub tenons that go on this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna draw the line where it needs to be. I'm gonna bandsaw the line, then I'm gonna take it over to the joiner and I'm gonna join it down to final size. And that'll get us where we need to be. So. Okay, so here we are. I've just set these in place. These are the tenons that go on these two. So this is basically what they're going to look like. Our next step is we're going to do our aprons, our curved aprons. We've already worked out the radiuses, and I've even made a couple of little templates out of 1/4-inch MDF to make it a little faster. The smaller vanity gets one large apron with a 12-foot radius on it, and the larger vanity gets 3 separate of these arches, and there will be a toe kick piece 3 inches recessed behind that arch. So that's our next step. Thank you. right, so now it's time to turn our attentions to the drawers. As you can see, our technician is cutting the dovetails for the side panels. This vanity has six drawers and they all happen to be the same size, which helps for production efficiency. So he uses his our jig and he cuts the dovetails, and it cuts the male and the female at the same time. So now he's going on to assemble the drawers. Little trough that we use there is actually sold as a joint compound trough, and it works really well for our purposes here because it's a quick way to glue all those dovetails. So he sets it up there and he gets the males glued, and then he presses the sides on like that. Actually, he's pressing the front and the back on right now. The sides are the ones with the dovetails on them cut. Now he takes the drawer bottom and he slides it in. Hopefully, if we've cut it properly, it fits perfectly, and seems to. Alrighty. So then he gets the other one, does the same thing, and then he starts to tap it down. So once he gets it tapped down, he's going to make sure it gets square. Okay, so we know the sides are parallel, therefore we can measure the diagonals. And we're very picky about this. It has to be within less than a 32nd of an inch in order for that drawer to be dead on square. It's very important to the function of the drawer that it be square. So this is how he does it. Now, once he gets it square, it'll hold that squareness reasonably well as long as he doesn't pick it up and carry it around. But being that we use bloom undermount slides, which are somewhat of an industry standard these days, he has to put the clips on there in their position to know where to put the blocks in their proper place. The blocks that he's putting on, and he's using hot glue, which is a really neat way to do it because hot glue holds real well. He can put those on. He can put a couple at the back and one at the front. He can put two in the front if the drawer is wider, but these are fairly small, so one will do the trick. Once those are in there, it glues the bottom panel to the side panels, and that drawer will stay square. So we don't have to worry about that anymore. Now he's just going to touch it up with the sander, because there's a little, when the glue dries, there's a little bit of a rough spot right on the dovetail, so he wants to smooth that down. And then he is ready to cut the fancy notching for the bloom slides. So as he puts the clips back on, he's going to screw them on. There's two screws in each clip that go into the front panel. And once he gets those secured, he has to cut his notches on the back and drill the holes. All right, so now he's just marking his notches. You don't really need to mark them for the exact width, but he likes to be very precise, so he did that. Now he's going to take our little Dremel tool, which we've found is the best way to do this, because unless you set up the table saw in a very fancy way, this is just the most efficient way to do it. So he cuts down through the back panel, right down to where the bottom panel is. Then he's going to cut those notches out flush. The Dremel tool, as I said, works great for this sort of thing. Once he gets those notches cut out, the only remaining machining to accommodate the bloom slides is there's a hole in the back, and we have a jig for that as well. Once the hole is in there, then once this is set into the bloom slides, which are already in the vanity, you'll push it back and you'll hear a nice solid click and they'll be in place. So now this is what we call in the industry a five-sided drawer, which is somewhat illogical. It has four sides and a front. But older drawers, the front used to be integral with the drawer box. We don't do that anymore. We make a separate box. The box will go into the vanity, and then we will take the fronts and we will mount them to the drawer box. And what he just put on was the two-sided tape that we use. There's other ways to do it. This one works well if you have a lot of drawers, and you're going to have difficulty with accessing it. So we use the double-faced tape, we usually call it. And then when all the drawer boxes are in, we will use spacers to make sure the drawer fronts are in their proper location. We will remove the tape, the covering on the tape, stick the drawer box in, then we'll pull the drawer box out of the vanity, put it face down, and put screws in it. So the two-sided tape only has to hold that front end there for a few minutes. Okay, the time has come to assemble all of our parts. They've all gone through finish. I've trimmed them to their net size. We've decided our setbacks on the front from the, you know, from the apron to the front edge of the bottom panel to the front edge of these tapered legs. The really unique feature of this vanity. So what I'm going to do is get the bottom panel prepared to attach to the side panels. And this is going to, you know, I need to attach our arch apron detail. This will be in the toe kick. So it goes on the bottom panel like this because I have it upside down here, and I'm going to screw it down. There are 6 drawers to mount in this cabinet. So that's a fair amount of these hefty slides. So the question is, do you want to assemble the cabinet, then come in and insert the slides and attach them to the carcass? I'm not going to do it that way on this one. I think if there was one drawer or two drawers, I would. But in this case, there's 6, and we have to put them on the center panels and on the side panels. This is one of the side panels right here. So I find it easier to mount these while they're still flat and horizontal here. I just think it's a hell of a lot easier. Okay, so we have all our drawer slides attached. This is the right-hand side. This whole cabinet goes into a niche in the wall, which has yet to be built by the contractor. So the only part of this that sticks out beyond the wall, the niche, is this part. The rest of it is disappeared in there. What that does is it's an advantage for us on assembly day because it means we have non-exposed sides. So that means I can screw right through them. That's a really nice feature. So now on the other vanity, one of the ends is finished, so I can't screw right through it. I have to use a cleat and do that, or use pocket screws. Either one will work. So anyway, we're going to start here with screwing it into this side panel. Okay, so now we have the two end panels on, and we're starting to get a sense of this cabinet, of what we were after here. You know, we have the arch here happening. This is the toe kick. It's a very real toe kick, so we rounded this edge. People with bare feet are going to be walking up to this every morning. So now we need to put on our center panels, and as I'm very big on using spacers rather than lines and coming up to the lines, I'm going to make a spacer. It's 13.5 inches. That will have our center panels in the correct spot, and of course the slides will face these slides. And since we've already made our drawer boxes, they will drop right in and snap into place. Nice and easy. Then we can go on to mounting the drawer fronts. But anyway, the next step is to mount these two center panels right in the center and then put the back panel on. And the last thing, construction-wise, is the overhead top plate, which will complete the cabinet, and then we just do the drawer fronts. Thank you. So now we have gotten the sink in from the customer. I required that I have it here to make sure it'll fit, because this is a very large sink for a very small vanity. So it's really tight in there. And the clearance here, I've measured it exactly where it's going to hit our center panels on our vanity, because I need to cut the center panels away from it to accommodate it. So I'm going to cut them down about 4 3/4. Now remember, there's a 7/8 inch piece that's going to go on top here when she's done. So the countertop goes on top of this. So the sink will hang down from under the countertop. So it comes from this top down. So if I come that 4 3/4 down, I'm going to clear by about 7/8. That's a comfortable dimension to clear by. So I'm just going to use my jigsaw and do it right here. We should be able to get, I've scribed a line here. So I'm going to follow that line with the jigsaw and then do a quick sanding job on it, and we'll put some stain on there. So after we get that done, then we're going to hang our fronts and put that top piece on and some trim, and then it'll be ready to take it over to the customer's house.